Hi there, Dr. Christel chiming in. Today on Ask Dr. Deb, we're gonna talk about body positivity. There are a lot of bloggers and social media influencers who use the phrase body positive, and I couldn't quite put my finger on what that movement meant and why it didn't sit right with me. So I wanna take a look at the history, the original intent, where we are today, and my thoughts moving forward. The history, from what I can tell, since 1996, the Body Positive Institution has been striving for reconnecting youth and adults to their innate body wisdom for more balanced, joyful self-care and a relationship with their whole selves that is guided by love, forgiveness, and humor, more recently defined on urbandictionary.com. Body positivity isn't just loving yourself, it's respecting yourself. And Wikipedia says, body positivity is acceptance and appreciation of all human body types. It is a social movement rooted in the belief that all human beings should have a positive body image and be accepting of their own bodies as well as the bodies of others. The movement sets forth the notion that that beauty is a construct of society and poses that this construct should not infringe upon one's ability to feel confidence or self-worth. Now, tell me if this sounds right to you. The original intent of the body positive movement was more about self-care and a deeper understanding of our whole selves, regardless of age, gender, race, or weight. However, where we are now focuses on respect and acceptance, and that all human beings should have a positive body image. It looks like it's evolved into another set of rules for how we should feel about our bodies and places personal responsibility and acceptance entirely on the individual. Now, this is where I think the movement started to change and perhaps lost its roots. I think it has changed into an idea that has a different meaning to every person. And we do see women using it as a way to kind of protect themselves by saying, I'm body positive. And in doing that, they're saying that you might think I'm insecure or should be because of the way I look, but I'm not. I'm body positive. I came across a dissertation about body positivity titled Towards a Radical Body Positive, Reading the Online Body Positive Movement. Now, this is by Alexandra Sastre, and she looked at several blogs and found that body positivity is making a move towards a healthier body image through a visually and textually recorded personal journey. And what that means is that people are recording their journeys through their body positivity journey. But what I noticed is that since our individual definitions of health are very, very skewed and also very different, becoming healthier looks different to most people, especially within the body positive movement. So she found that the blog Psych Central offers a primer for creating a body positive manifesto. And it states, don't let others rule how you feel about beauty or yourself. And whether you lose or gain weight, you're still the same person and you deserve love and respect either way. And it was this statement that perfectly identified the problem of the movement for me. I do not think that we act the same way at different body weights. While yes, we are the same human, and of course we deserve equality, we do embody different behaviors because we know that through empirical research, people are treated differently based on body size. And I don't think that no matter how much willpower you have, you cannot override or overpower beliefs that may have been internalized or put upon you because those beliefs inform how we feel about ourselves. For example, we know that researchers found that 10% of women and 5% of men had experienced discrimination based on their weight, including being rejected for a job, that overweight women are paid less than their male colleagues across a variety of industries, and weight bias and stigma can reduce the quality of care for larger patients, despite the best intentions of healthcare providers that want to provide high quality care. The consequences of being fat are detrimental and go beyond the individual's ability to feel positive about themselves. The fact is that people treat you better when you're thin. Body positivity was a place where all bodies were okay, but now it feels like more of a place that insists you should feel good about yourself, which is just another impossible standard. It's also been merged with weight loss journeys and women documenting their journeys to body positivity through weight loss. And at first I felt really annoyed, like respecting your body and, in my opinion, body positivity wasn't about weight loss or sculpting your bodies to be another shape or simply conform to our ideal of beauty. But then again, as a feminist scholar, I believe that everyone's experience is valid, and whatever words they want to use to describe their lived experience is 100% their right. However, if the intention of the movement was to help people of all body shape, size, color, and identifications, but it's now used by mostly women who are attempting to conform to the traditional ideals of beauty or are in the process of attaining that, then I think the movement has lost its way. And our bodies are not the problem. I follow a blogger and writer, Your Fat Friend, and they also wrote about this topic on medium.com. Your Fat Friend says, "I do not need positivity or acceptance any more than I need tolerance. These are passive expressions, not nearly powerful enough to end the unceasing assault on fat bodies. Over time, I've come to realize that I do not need body positivity. What I need is justice." And I couldn't agree more. Telling fat women and men, fat people, to love themselves when they are subject to systemic discrimination isn't realistic. It is not an individual thing where we each need to be at peace with our own bodies. If it was that easy, we'd all do it and we'd already be there. But it's not a realistic goal when the systems in place and treatment of fat people are designed to make them feel like they don't belong or fit into our culture. So where do we go from here? I think that language is really important, and that considering words without dual meaning, such as justice, is a really good step forward. And perhaps we all as people are in varying stages of grief when it comes to understanding our bodies and what health actually means. We know that medical doctors have been wrong before, and I think some people are really angry about fat acceptance because the idea that a fat person likes themselves or that a fat body is perfectly healthy is just too much to grasp. But perhaps body positivity is a really good stepping stone that makes sense to some people and is a safe place. I say for those who are ready, we move forward to body justice. But perhaps this is too conceptual as well. I think it's okay to use the term body positivity, but I don't think it's addressing the real issue. To me, I think we need legal action towards equality for fat bodies. Being fat is the last acceptable form of discrimination in our country. Michigan is the only state with laws protecting fat bodies. We must legally protect fat people to ensure equality. I don't think it's about self-love and self-acceptance. We can change the world. We've done it before. And I don't know, I just might see if I can meet with my state representative, Patty Murray, to talk about how we can help protect fat people. What do you think? Send Dr. DC to DC? Thanks so much for watching my video today about body positivity. Does it still mean the same thing to you after watching this video? I hope I was able to give you a new perspective, and let me know if you have any questions. Much love to you all, and we'll catch you on the flippity flip. I wonder how many times I'm gonna say body positive, body positivity, body positive, body positive, body positivity, body positivity, a positive body positive, positive body, body, body positive, body positive, body positive, body positivity, body positive, body positive, body positive, body positive. Positivity, body positive, body positive, body positive, body positivity, body positivity, and body positivity, we body positivity, body positivity, body positivity, body positivity.
Woo!
Watch me! Psych. I wrote the rule book on them games. No, they wouldn't really be listening. Right. They would just be not looking at
what?
Us. Yeah. They'd be counting how many times I'm saying body positive. Oh yeah.
Yeah, baby!
The whole body positivity thing is hard because when you don't feel good about yourself, it's like you failed body positivity.
Mm-hmm.
Like you can't be successful if you have days where you're insecure about your body, but I think it's impossible in the world we live in where you're just surrounded by people telling you how you have to look all the time, not to have days when you don't feel good about your body.
Yeah, and then on a day when you don't feel good and you're trying to be body positive, you feel bad about feeling bad about your body.
And it just needs, the conversation shouldn't be about how you feel about your personal body. It's how people get treated because of their bodies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it.
Get it, girl.
Get it, girl. Thanks for stopping by.
Bye.
Catch you on the flippity flip.